Winter Choral Concert. We are so glad to see all of you. Would you give one more round of applause to our Madrigal singers? So tonight you're going to hear quite a collection of different songs, some from the season now, some actually lurking for other seasons. And the one that we're going to start off with is called Ide Kisholm. It's in Hungarian, which if you study linguistics and different language groups, you'll know that there's all these European languages that are all tied together, and then there's this little pocket of Hungarian that has nothing to do with anything else. And when I asked a couple people, hey, can you help me pronounce this? They said, no, it's Hungarian. No one can speak Hungarian, which is a very challenging language to do, but you're going to hear a little bit of that tonight. The song is about cherries ripening, blossoming, singing, dancing, because we're going to make it through the cold.
I'm gonna go to the
Silver bells tinkling and ringing, but what we didn't put into your program is that the text is by Edgar Allan Poe, which is kind of odd for a Christmas-type song. We actually went through and found the whole poem. The first verse is about Christmas bells, then the second verse of the poem, which Levitt didn't set, is about wedding bells, the third verse is about fire alarm bells, and then, of course, it's Edgar Allan Poe, and the fourth stanza is all about funeral bells, because it's Poe, and this is what happens. But we're just going to give you the first verse of the poem tonight, All About Sleigh Bells by John Lennon.
Hear the sledges with the bells, silver bells, silver bells. What a world of merry that their melody foretells.
Does an Ave Maria. didn't quite work out that way. So this is our first one. You're going to hear two Ave Marias tonight. This is the first one. Treble Choir and Hoffman Singers are actually going to combine forces to make this wonderful, massive women's choir up here for you. And they're going to bring you Camille Saint-Saëns' Ave Maria. A little later, you'll hear concert choir and bass choir combined together for the other one.
Then I'll go.
The next piece we're going to sing for you is called This Little Babe, and it's from Benjamin Britten's Ceremony of Carols. It's originally written for women's choir and harp. Mrs. Chappell is going to do a fantastic job imitating a harp for us this evening, as she always does. Actually, would you give her a round of applause? Benjamin Britten had been commissioned to write a harp concerto, and he was traveling from the United States to England on a boat and had plenty of time to, and finished up the harp concerto in the first couple of days. Well, he had picked up this book of old English poems and said, well, I got pen, paper, harp in my head. I guess I'm just going to write a whole bunch of songs because I'm bored. I wish I could do this kind of masterwork when I was bored. They've turned out to be one of his greatest creations and are performed every year. In fact, in Chicago, this weekend, I believe it is, a group called Bella Voce, who I sing with sometimes, not at the moment with this one, but they are performing all of these Ceremony of Carols with a harp and nine women singing. Probably why I'm not singing in this one. So, if you want to look it up, Bella Voce, it is an incredible group, and it'll be an incredible performance. But tonight we're going to bring you This Little Babe. And the text is, this little babe so few days old has come to rifle Satan's fold. All hell doth at his presence quake, though he himself for cold do shake. The whole poem is contrasting this little tiny baby and demonic warfare. It's quite cool, and it's really neat for our advanced women's group to get to sing this really quite powerful text. So we bring you Benjamin Britten's This Little Babe.
Seasons of love.
It is actually in Russian, and it is by the composer Sergei Rachmaninoff, and it's from a piece that he wrote called the All Night Vespers, and it's just a piece of Russian choral music, very typical of the time period and of the style, but it's just got these beautiful, lush, deep Russian choral sounds that you don't get in any other kind of choral music. It's actually been a challenge for us to learn it because it's a different kind of singing and a different kind of approach than we've been used to. In this one, we have our bass choir joining us, and so we are going to bring you concert choir and bass choir, Bogorodice Diev.
Thank you.
So one of the things that really inspires me as a choral director when I choose music is text. I'm both a band person and a choral person. I double majored in college. I love both, but one of the reasons that I do what I do is because I just love languages of all different kinds. I hope that you've been able to see that tonight. We've done Spanish, English, Hungarian, Russian, just the whole gamut of different things. I think it's one of the beautiful experiences of being in choir and getting to sing choral music. But I also really love a good English text. And this next piece by Gerald Finzi has one of those. The poet was the poet laureate of England, and the piece is called My Spirit Sang All Day. And the poet plays with the phrase that says, "Oh my joy," and uses that phrase over and over again in the song to tie the different pieces up together. He talks about his eyes and his ears and his tongue all talking about joy. And Gerald Finzi, who is one of the most characteristic English composers of English choral music, took this text that was very English and said it just about the time he was about to get married. And of course, the woman he got married to was named Joy. So I think this had a special meaning to him, and we bring you My Spirit Sang All Day by Gerald Finzi.
My spirit sang all day, oh my joy, nothing my tongue could say, only my joy.
My heart in echo caught,
oh my joy, and spake, tell me my thoughts, I'm not thy joy.
My eyes can peer around, oh my joy,
what beauty has thou found? Show us thy joy. My jealousy is grew whist, oh my joy, music from heaven is sent for our joy. She also came and heard, oh my joy, what said she is this word? And so I chopped a pear tree down.
we come to our final piece, and it has been a very long tradition here at Hoffman and Saints High School to end the and our choral concert here in the winter with the Hallelujah Chorus. So if we've got anyone in the audience that falls into one of these categories, number one, you're an alumni, you need to get up here and sing with us. I have music, if you've forgotten, it's okay. Number two, if you're all of our choirs, we're bringing them up here. Number three, if you know the Hallelujah Chorus and you would like to come up here and sing it, you are absolutely welcome to come up here and join us. Don't be shy. I've got music. I will make sure you have it. There are people around you that will take care of you. The more, the merrier. And if you're not quite sure how it goes, you just kind of remember, that's okay. Come on anyway. We'll take you. We got lots of room on the horizon. Season and enjoy Hallelujah by George Frederick Henry.